The update to Final Cut 10.4.9 had a number of smaller features, and one of those is the custom overlay feature. And I thought this is a good opportunity to have a look at the other overlays that Final Cut has that are built in. For those of you using Final Cut to produce YouTube videos, I've produced a specific overlay which is downloadable for free. I'm Bruce Macbryde, and my goal is to improve your knowledge and to speed up your workflow in Final Cut. In the description below, there are timestamps that will take you to different parts of this video. There's no doubt YouTube is a good place to learn Final Cut, but not all of your questions are answered in pre-recorded videos. So if you need that little bit of extra support, then click the link below and we can remotely, over Skype or Zoom, share your screen and I can fix your problems for you. So let's have a look where the overlays are kept in Final Cut. If we come up to the View menu, we can see them here. There's the Show Title and Action Safe Zone. And when you turn this on, you have two sets of lines. The internal line is where your video titles should stay. Now, this is not so much important for flat panel TVs, but it is still important if people are using older style televisions where the edges can sometimes be cut off. This is not an issue for the internet or for YouTube videos. The external or the outer line is what's called the action line, and this is where your action should be retained. So if we look in this one here, that action line, the boat is going to go out of the action line, even though it's on the screen for you to see. But just to add a point about YouTube, you'll find that YouTube subtitles will take up part of the lower part of the screen. So this might be handy if you are having your subtitles show on your screens in YouTube. The second overlay that is provided by Apple is the Show Horizon. And this simply shows you the horizon and a vertical line. And you can see the horizon here in this shot. And you can see how in some places the horizon is slipping away from the horizontal. And selecting on the transform, you could select on the clip and you can change the horizon. And if you want to do this on different portions of the clip, then you can use this with keyframes. And I have a video about keyframes, and if you click the eye above, you'll be able to go to that video and see how to set keyframes in Final Cut's viewer. And the third choice is custom overlays. So you could create your own custom overlays and select them at this point here. So if you go to choose custom overlay, you can see that one of them is selected here. So that one selected now will now be turned on. And this is the YouTube one. So you can see there's the eye on YouTube. And this is for the default screen on the computers for YouTube. You can see the play button, the volume controls, and the subtitle menu there. All of the overlays can be turned on together. And also notice on the custom overlay, you can select the amount of opacity. So at the moment, this one's showing 100% of the opacity. If I want to take that down to 50%, then it's not so obvious when you're working with the screen, but it's still there if you need to look for it. And then finally, if we look at the custom overlay, you can see this is where you can add the overlays. So this will take you to your hard disk. And it will also reveal in Finder where those custom overlays are kept and what folder they're kept in. And if you want to there, then you can delete the ones that you don't want to keep or ones that are duplicated. And for those of you wondering, the overlays do not show when you export your video. They are purely there for a viewing purpose while you're editing. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Please like and subscribe and press the bell. There are new videos every Sunday.